So I'm going to switch it up a little bit because I'm sitting and I'm thinking to myself, for some reason I'm a little uncomfortable and I'm trying to figure out again for myself, why is it so? And I spoke in front of big audiences in the past. And I think to me is, if I can start with some questions, that would kind of ease me up a bit. So I assume everybody's an immigrant, right, in this room? Right? Okay, good to go. So who is inspired to start a business or just thinking about starting a business? One, two, three. You're still thinking? We'll talk to you. So three, four people thinking about starting a business. How many people have actually started the business? And have the business, except the panel. Okay? And let's just say in a span of 5 to 6 years or 1 to 2 years, running the businesses. Okay, awesome. So at least we know the context where to go with this. So I think I have a pretty similar spiel as everybody else. I'm an immigrant, came to the United States in about 2005. Not a word of English, really difficult. Came to New York. My family's friends met me in New York, and I thought I'm going to be the coolest kid on the planet because now I'm going to be in New York. And they took me to New Jersey. And the first morning I woke up, I was like, where the tall buildings are? And they're like, well, you're going to sit in this townhouse for a couple of days, and then we're going to go to New York. And it's been really tough for me because I like energy, I like to move around. And for 2 days, I was literally sitting with two cats and just doing nothing pretty much and looking at my one little suitcase that I had. And it's funny because I remember when I came here, I literally did not know the difference between the monitor and the hard drive. So if you put the two next to me, it was the same. And so I couldn't even turn on their computers and Facebook wasn't around, so it was pretty boring. And then in 2 days after, they took me to New York. And I'll just try to paint the picture for you. So I'm sitting in a car, we're driving on the highway, and I see the New York, right, Manhattan. I'm like so excited, I'm gonna see Manhattan now. And then I see Manhattan, and I see Manhattan, and I see Manhattan, and I don't see Manhattan. And so I'm like, so where are we going? They're like, no, you're gonna see it, it's gonna be awesome. And I'm like, all right, I think I know where we're going. And so they slowly park the car, I leave outside, and the first thing I hear, my second day in the United States, right, I'm supposed to be in New York, and the thing that I hear is, куда пошел козел? And I'm like, all right, so where am I? And now it was Brooklyn. And so that's how my journey started in the United States. In 5 years, I ended up here in Chicago, and since then I stayed here. And I think what's really interesting is, my whole life, my whole kind of like, call it success or whatever, I just look at it very simple. My whole purpose in life was, since I was a kid, was if somebody went one way, I'm gonna go a different way. It doesn't matter what that is, even if somebody was super successful and somebody will say, well, that guy made a shitload of money, I'm gonna go in a completely different direction because I don't care about that part. I'm always excited about being the trailblazer. And so when I came, my goal actually to come to the United States was just to buy a BMW and get the hell out of here and go back to my hometown, Ufa. And so I thought that this is gonna be my goal, then I realized that this is the country to stay. And I remember the conversation, and I think for some of you guys who are planning to start a business, I just want to remind how great it is to be in the United States, is I have a conversation with a guy who came here, it's 42 years old, from Ukraine, had nothing, literally nothing, with two kids, and he built a business, now he lives in Ravenswood, and him and I are talking, and he's like, you can start a business. I said, seriously? He's like, yeah. And back in Russia, I had like a couple different weird businesses, I'm not going to go deep into that, but he's like, you want to start a business? I'm like, yeah, I'm super inspired. He's like, you should do it. I said, well, how? He's like, it's super simple to do it in the United States. I'm like, so what am I supposed to do? He's like, fill out a paper, send it, open the bank account, and you're good to go. I'm like, really? He's like, yeah. And I remember how tough it is in Russia, so I asked him, I said, look, is somebody gonna knock on my door? He's like, nope. I'm like, so if I pay taxes, and it's all legit, I can stay? He's like, yep. I'm like, that's it, I'm staying. So that was my deciding moment. I decided to stay, then learn the English. And then back in 2007, 6 and 7, I had some friends. Ivan is actually one of my best friends. And before I met him and the rest of my friends, I had some really weird friends. And so we would hang out and they were in real estate. And if you guys remember before the bubble, real estate was the place. Everybody wanted to be in real estate. And literally you sell 3 houses, you drive a BMW. And then at that moment, I went to school and college. I was like, wow, I don't think I'm going to be that because it's just not interesting. And all of these friends in real estate were making fun of me. And then in 2007, right when I was in college, I started this business called Siegel Construction, and I literally started it on a check, and the guy even spelled the name wrong, and I did not have the business, the bank account, nothing. He wrote a check, he's like, go do it, go figure out what you want to do. And then I'm looking at the check, I'm like, all right, so where's the bank account? And so I had to find the bank, deposit the bank, and it's a long story. But the point was that that business was not sexy at all. It was just a simple construction business in a tough time, which I didn't know, I don't read the news, and I didn't know the economy was gonna go down. But what's really interesting, in 6 months, all these friends that were fancy in real estate, they started knocking on my door because I had shitload of work and they didn't have anything. And so at that point, I realized that, my passion to go for something that's not been done before is gonna be interesting. And so slowly, I built the Siegel Construction. We started doing some interesting stuff with dental offices, which is also was interesting because usually Russians don't get into the dental offices. They like to own, but nothing related to dental offices. And so I got in, I loved it. Yep, and so kudos to dental. And so I got in and I got inspired because it was a really good, interesting industry, and I thought that I'm gonna make it, so, which I did. I sold my first business, I got out of it pretty quickly because I realized that that was my ceiling. And it's actually an interesting story too. I went on a website to find one of my competitors that was building dental practices in Texas and Washington and all the states, and they grew the business where now they're becoming a nationwide company. And so I literally went on the website, I saw the name of the CEO of the company, and there was an email. I sent him an email, and I say, hey, can I meet you? In 5 minutes, he responded back like, fly over to Dallas. In 10 minutes, I bought the tickets and I flew down there. And so I sat down with him and said, look, how is it to build a business in our niche? And he's like, it sucks. I'm like, literally? Like, is it really? He's like, it sucks, get out of it. I'm like, why? He's like, I'm scaling down. You can't build a business in this, what we do, nationwide. And I mean, you guys know, right? I asked you, you're all immigrants. You know how it is when somebody says there's a ceiling. If there's a ceiling, I want to get out of it, because at least when I bought the tickets to the United States, I was told that A, money grow on the tree, and B, is there's no ceiling, right? So I'm kind of inspired by both of these things. And now, you know, when I learned that, I decided to sell, then I started another business, and I quickly realized that it's gonna be a failure. And then I started the third one, which is called Zen Supplies. It's basically the inventory, it's an inventory management system for dental practices, which is really boring, I'm not gonna go into it. But that business allows me pretty much to do what I wanna do. A lot of people, I think, start businesses for their own reasons. We can talk about that. There's a lot of people that just, right now the times are good, it's fancy. I still meet a lot of people that just want to say they're entrepreneurs, and I think some of you guys will agree with me that there's a ton of wantrepreneurs. And to Dima's point is that, you know, there's a lot of business out there, and if you really want to hustle and if you really want to work hard, it's out there, it's possible, but anybody who's inspired to start a business, it's going to be 24/7. There's no Saturday, there's no Friday night. And my friends can agree with that you're working nonstop, and people will make fun of you. You just need to smile and say, yeah, I'll see you on the other side.